And now we're going to look at the rationals on the number line, and not all the rationals. We're going to do the repeating decimals. Zoom in on the unit value. That is subdivided into tenths, and the decimal points are put in. And now between 0.6 and 0.7, we expand that and put in the hundredths. Now we zoom in a little further between 66 hundredths and 67 hundredths, and the next subdivision will be to the thousandth level. But you can see we're already running out of room. The process continues forever. You keep repeating the same decimal division. And down below, it looks something like this. You're always taking 6/10 of the previous subdivision, and you keep going forever and ever. And I'll look at one irrational, the square root of 2, which has a simple continued fraction development. I put the visual analogy next to the arithmetic. This way you can see an organized pattern, which is not based on decimal division of the number line. Nevertheless, an organized pattern. It's developed more completely in the infinite continued fraction video. Next, we'll look at the most common transcendental, pi. The number is based on the ratio of the circumference to the diameter of the circle, and it has no relation to the, decimal division of the number line. And you can approximate it to the decimal line with this kind of organized continued fraction pattern. Adding in the negatives, you'd get this kind of number line. The theory is that the reals fill in all the spaces between them. I'll deal with that separately at a later video.